Your world-class dealer in Bedford, Pennsylvania. Family Mobile Homes, Route 220 North Altoona.
Live from the Jack of Mosque in Altoona, Pennsylvania, the 1986 Miss Pennsylvania Scholarship Pageant. Pennsylvania Singers, Ron Decker and the Miss Pennsylvania Orchestra. Special guest, Miss Pennsylvania 1984, Gina Major. 26 lovely representatives of the Keystone State and Johnny Corazzo, noted music composer and performing artist.
Thank you.
Johnny Purrazzo.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody, and good evening. Indeed, we've got success tonight because we're going to be celebrating the 1986 Miss Pennsylvania Scholarship Pageant. And tonight we're going to be celebrating the young women and the selection in our 66th year of Miss Pennsylvania, our official representative to the Miss America pageant in Atlantic City. And I'm pleased that we tonight can capture all the excitement and the nervousness of this pageant. It's going to be fun, and what a great audience you are tonight. It's nice to see all you out there. Yeah! As most of you know, tonight's pageant is a state preliminary of the Miss America pageant, which is the largest women's scholarship foundation in the world. Tell you what, let's not wait any longer. It's time to meet 26 of the loveliest women in the state of Pennsylvania. One of them will be Miss Pennsylvania, 1986. Miss Buck County.
Good evening. My name is Susan Christian. My hometown is New Hope, and I'd like to extend a special thank you to my sponsors here in Altoona, the Height Company.
Miss Lehigh Valley.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Joette Rigolonis, and my local pastor is Helen Whitehall. And a special thanks to Pepsi.
Miss Lancaster County.
Good evening. My name is Kathy Lynn Keith, and my local pageant was held in Ephrata. I'd like to say thank you to People's Styling Shop.
Miss Western Pennsylvania.
Good evening. I'd first like to thank Blue and White Travel for sponsoring my stay in Elkin this week. My name is Michelle Wood, and I was crowned in Bedford.
Miss Lebanon Valley.
Good evening. I'm Kathy Wagner, and I'm originally from Anvil, Pennsylvania. My sponsor tonight is People's Natural Gas Company.
Miss Central Pennsylvania.
Good evening. I'm Stephanie Dovis. My local pageant was held in Altoona's backyard, Hollidaysburg, Pennsylvania. A special thank you to SKF Industries for sponsoring me here in Altoona. Thank you.
Miss Northeastern Pennsylvania.
Hi, everybody. I'm Valerie Kalantar. My hometown is Brookshire, PA, and my local sponsor is People's Styling Shop.
Miss Armstrong County.
Hello, I'm Courtney Pendleton. I'd like to thank my local sponsor, the AMBUP Sport Organization, and my hometown is Lord City.
Miss Perth County.
Hello, I'm Diane Marie Young, and my hometown is Temple, and I'd like to thank Whittinger's IGA.
Miss Pocono.
Good evening, my name is Carla Jenkins. I'd like to send a warm thank you to Kaufman's in Altoona, and my hometown is Popsville.
Miss Clinton County.
Good evening. I'm Kathy Clinton. My local is held in Deepwoods Country, Clayton County. And I'd like to thank my sponsor in Altoona, Sutterick. Thank you.
Miss Greater Harrisburg.
Miss
Greater Wilkesboro, Scranton area.
Well, I'm Darlene D. send a personal thank you to my sponsors for a great week at our dinner, the U.S. National Bank.
Miss Indiana University of Pennsylvania.
Good evening. My name is Jennifer Bradley and my hometown is McMurray, Pennsylvania. I'd like to extend a very special welcome and thank you to the Height Company.
Miss York County.
I live in the White Rose City of York. Kaufman's of Altoona is my local sponsor. Thank you, Kaufman. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Rosalyn Elias.
Miss Crawford County.
Good evening. My name is Alice Nogello. My hometown is Peoples, Pennsylvania. And I'd like to thank the Pepsi Company for sponsoring me.
People of Pennsylvania have gotten to know a beautiful, talented, and friendly young woman. She has worn the crown with class and dignity. Tonight, her reign officially ends, but we'll all warmly remember Miss Pennsylvania 1985, Leah Shiazza. Thank you, Leah. Ladies and gentlemen, during this busy week, a week of rehearsals, preliminary competitions, and performances, points have been accumulated by our 26 contestants. Ballots were cast in each phase of preliminary competition, private interview, evening gown, swimsuit, and talent, for the five most outstanding contestants in that particular competition. From these tabulations, 10 finalists have emerged, and we come to this exciting moment. We note, however, that points earned up to this time, in other words, points earned prior to tonight, will all be disregarded. I'm kind of excited. Like, I don't want to do this, but I have to. I love all these girls. Ladies and gentlemen, the top 10 finalists vying for the title of Miss Pennsylvania 1986 are... Number 17, Jennifer Bradley. Number 13, Darlene Dealey, Miss Greater Woodsboro, Trenton area. Number 6, Stephanie Jean Gilbert, Miss Central Pennsylvania. Number 23, Gina Redmond, Miss Penn State University. Number 10, Carla Marie Jenkins, Miss Pocono. Number 22, Dana Patterson, Miss Laurel Highland. Number 14, Cheryl Ann Bergen, Miss Southwestern Pennsylvania. Number 26, Michelle Lynn Klein, Miss Philadelphia. Number 1, Susan Christman, Miss Buck County. Ladies and gentlemen, the top Scholarship Pageant is an honor and a challenge for our judges. And tonight, they have to select the next Miss Pennsylvania, hopefully the next Miss America. loud and exciting performance, let's go to our first round of competition. Presenting our Miss Pennsylvania finalists in swimsuit competition. Number 17, Jennifer Bradley, Miss Indiana University of Pennsylvania.
Thank you.
introduce a young lady you know very well. She's going to explain to us a little bit of how the judging is working right now in the swimsuit competition. I want you to make her feel at home. Miss Pennsylvania, 1984, Gina Major. Gina.
Tell you a little bit about the swimsuit competition. It's designed to give our judges an opportunity to see how well the contestant has maintained good physical fitness. She should have a good figure that reflects good health, projection of personality, poise, grace, carriage, and radiance are likewise considered as the swimsuit and the young woman in it are judged with no relation to their other qualifications. Ladies, would you please reverse position? While our judges are completing their ballots, I'd like to tell you a little bit about some of the volunteers with the Miss Pennsylvania Fellowship Pageant. It's the volunteers that make the program work. And to be specific, there are 475 volunteers that give their time to the Miss Pennsylvania Scholarship Pageant Program to make it work. How about a round of applause for all those people out there, manning the lights, producing the show, dressing the girls backstage. We thank you for your time. The 10 young ladies that you see on stage here tonight are here representing 5% of all of the contestants that began at the local preliminary level in the state of Pennsylvania from a field of 431. And I think the judges are ready. So I thank you, ladies. How about a round of applause? Our 10 finalists in swimsuit competition. Thank you, ladies. Very important information to share with you regarding our scholarship favorite, Saving All My Love for You, joined by the Miss Pennsylvania dancers, Tony Colucci and Mindy McCabe. Enjoy.
It's not So hard
Now, some folks thrive on fresh country air and peaceful surroundings. Not Darlene Dealey, our next contestant, whose energetic and precise gymnastic routine reveals her attraction to city life. Please welcome Miss Greater Wilkesboro, Scranton area, Darlene Dealey. Darlene?
I never dreamed.
the funniest part and the best part about the talent competition is watching the stage moms backstage, their faces. You would think that they were the girls' own mothers. God bless them. Stephen King has made us believe that a car can come to life in the movie Christine, a child can become the object of a national security and fire starter, and that a gypsy curse can almost come true in Thinner. Tonight, Gina Redmond breathes life into another terrifying journey as she performs a dramatic narration from Salem's Lot. Ladies and gentlemen, Gina Redmond, Miss Penn State University.
You know, I love to imagine. And the one thing I love to imagine about it is horror. Enter my imagination with me. Let me take you through a horrifying moment in Stephen King's novel. I picture in my mind a small boy and a middle-aged man. They're standing in front of the basement door of the old Marston house, the home of the master. The man outstretches his right arm, placing his hand upon the cool, smooth doorknob of the entrance. Slowly and pushes the door open. The man summons the boy, and together they descend the steps leading into the basement. The boy looks to his right and to his left, spotting a long knees shaking, hands trembling. They move towards the destination. The man removes his shot with a snake and hammer on his backpack. Gently, he lifts the lid of the coffin.
Did you jump? In this year of paying tribute to a great American symbol of freedom, the Statue of Liberty, our next contestant, Carla Marie Jenkins, raises her voice and song to our great country and to a great American composer, her beloved teacher, Fred Waring. In memory of the last song he composed and performed by Mr. Waring, the Pennsylvanians, Ms. Jenkins pays tribute to her teacher and his vision by singing My America. Ladies and gentlemen, Carla Marie Jenkins, Miss Pocono.
Beautiful.
Exhibiting ingenuity, flexibility, and great control is Dana Patterson. Miss Laurel Highland. Dana?
It's my will that I want to have a little pride.
combines simple German folk tunes and classic operatic writing in one of his finest operas. It's called The Magic Flute. In it, the Queen of the Night uses both gentle ploys and diabolical rage in a symbolic battle between good and evil. A medley of the Queen of the Night's arias, dramatizing both faces, will be performed now by Michelle Lynn Klein, Miss Philadelphia.
Bring back.
The talent competition is the single aspect that sets the Miss America pageant apart from most other pageants. The Miss America pageant, both scholarship monies and competition points are awarded. The judges are now casting ballots, ranking five of the most outstanding finalists in this competition, with no relation to other qualifications. For each of the five ranked positions, the points received in talent are twice the points received in private interview, evening gown, or in swimsuit competitions. Ladies and gentlemen, Leah Shiazza, Miss Pennsylvania 1985, distinguished herself last year as in the Miss America finals, and she was named a non-finalist talent winner. She will now distinguish herself further with the perennial favorite, Bye Bye Blacker, joined by Tony, Paul, and Leon. Ladies and gentlemen, Leah Shiazza. Leah.
Yeah.
ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce the president of the board of directors.
Which is Marie McLaughlin, Miss Pennsylvania 1976. Marie's coming back to celebrate her 10th anniversary. Miss Pennsylvania, 1978. Yeah, I told she came in. She was coming down from State College. Okay. There she is. I told you she's here. Thank you, Charmaine. Go ahead and walk down, Brooke. Charmaine just drove in from State College, so we just give her all the directions. Miss Pennsylvania, 1981, Jill Schaefer. Miss Pennsylvania, 1982, Laurie Hixonball. Pennsylvania 1984 and part of our production staff, Gina Major. Thank you, Gina.
Thank you. graduate of Grove City College, and I hold a Bachelor of Science degree in mathematics. I was crowned Miss Butler County in the Butler Intermediate High School, where I teach algebra. I have 150 delightful math students, some of whom were on the stage crew the night I was crowned. I love my work.
Number 14, Cheryl Ann Bergen, Miss Southwestern Pennsylvania.
Miss America's scholarship program has enhanced me as a woman. As a 25-year-old graduate of the University of Pittsburgh, I hold a master's degree in social work. Presently, I am a therapist working for Catholic Charities of the Diocese of Pittsburgh. I also enjoy a career as a freelance soloist and continue my study of voice at Carnegie Mellon University.
You
one who did not compete as a finalist. This special scholarship award is presented to contestant number 9, Diane Young, Miss Berger County. Congratulations, Diane. Congratulations. You know, this is the first pageant I've been involved in, and it has been a treat for me and an honor. And I have to say a few things. First of all, for every one of these beautiful young girls on stage, or for every two of them, rather, there's a local family who has housed them and fed them and taken care of them. Ladies and gentlemen, these people are fantastic who work with this pageant. I know the girls will all agree with me. I think we ought to give all these Altoona families a nice big round of applause. New queen will be drawing near. But first, let's welcome back a young lady who has worn the crown with class and dignity. Ladies and gentlemen, the very lovely Leah Shiaza, Miss Pennsylvania, 1985. Bidding farewell. Leah.
Now that I am at the conclusion of my reign and taking my final walk as Miss Pennsylvania, I would like to express just what this year has meant to me. It is hard to sum up all the wonderful things that have happened during the 12 months that I have worn the crown. Traveling the state and part of the country, flying for the first time, participating in the Miss America pageant and being recognized for my talent, and most of all, meeting and making new friends across Pennsylvania have all made this year extremely fulfilling and exciting. I have so many people to thank. The Pageant family, for they are so giving of their time. The Nyland family, for making their house my home. My own family, for being so supportive throughout this year. And I thank God every day for giving me this opportunity to grow and mature. So, as this chapter in my life is being closed, I can only wish the best for the new Miss Pennsylvania and hope that her year will be as rewarding as mine. Although this is the end of my reign, please believe that with this year, I hold many cherished memories. Thank you, everyone, and God bless you all.
Started and these young women started again, competing in swimsuit, evening gown, and talent, with private interview ballot also being cast. In a moment, one of these young women will become Miss Pennsylvania 1986. However, let's again meet our top 10 finalists. Jennifer Bradley. Evelyn Deal. Darlene Beely. Four phases of competition, which were private interview, evening gown, talent, and swimsuit. Five finalists have emerged, and the judges have cast final ballots, selecting the most qualified winner from among the five finalists. The young woman who will be named Miss Pennsylvania 1986 and also compete for the title of Miss America. The other four finalists will be named runners-up to the Court of Honor. Mr. Judges, Chairman, may I have the envelope, please? Thank you. Richmond. Number one, Miss Bucks County. Second runner-up, Gina Redmond, 23. Thank you.